You probably know the story already. It goes like this. It starts with a group of friends sharing a meal, breaking bread, enjoying each other's company. But he knew those friendships would be broken that very night. He would be lied to, denied, and sold out by the very men who surrounded him. But he celebrated with them anyway. Why? What was he thinking? In the garden, he's at his very lowest while crying through blood-stained tears. His friends are asleep, and then one comes to arrest him. But he loves them anyway. Why? What could possibly be in his mind to show such overwhelming grace? He's set up in illegitimate trials. He's slapped, beaten, cursed, mocked, and spat upon. But through it all, he turns the other cheek. Why would he do that? Why would he choose to endure this? The long walk to his execution begins. He carries the heavy timber up a dusty hill. The nails pierce and tear his flesh. His agony is excruciating. But the worst part is that his source of strength, his father, feels so far away. He is willingly doing this. He doesn't have to take on this pain. He could stop it all right now if he wanted to. But he doesn't. Why? What was he thinking? He did it because we were on his mind. I'm Matthew West, and this Easter weekend, we celebrate the God who has you and me on his mind.
I've read the words in red, how you leave the 99 to find the one missing. Feels like that was written with me on your mind. Who am I that the King